FM News. On point.
Negatives. The Election Commission has warned presidential candidates against establishing private tally centers ahead of the general elections. The chairperson of the commission, Justice Simon Mujenyi-Byabakama, sounded the warning while flagging off voting material to 9 upcountry districts, including Busia, Butambala, Iganga, Kasese, and Sironko, among others. Byabakama says tallying and declaration of votes is the work of the Election Commission.
Under the law, there is only one recognized tally center. That is the National Tally Center for Presidential Elections and then the District Tally Center for parliamentary and the other category of elections in the district. So I do not understand the rationale of this tally center and what its position is in the law. It's not there. In any case, the commission has said and the law commands or requires that to give every candidate a copy of the declaration of results from each polling station.
Meanwhile, Byabakama has also asked politicians to avoid mobilizing their voters to stay at the polling station after casting their vote because it exposes them to COVID-19.
You know, I have had some candidates telling their people, some of these polling stations, you know, some of the polling stations in Kampala, they cannot even accommodate 30 people. Now, if you are going to encourage 1,000 voters at that polling station to remain around, what are you doing? Be careful, you may end up losing your votes even, you the candidate. Because should these people start any chaos or confusion at that polling station that leads to disruption, then forget what has come from that polling station is dead.
The judiciary is cautioned for Law Development Center students caught on the video dancing to a popular local tune. Tumbis at the Kamasho court during working hours went viral on social media. In a circular released today by the judiciary, the four female students who are on a four-month clerkship program have since accepted their unprofessional conduct and apologized in writing. Kamasho court judge Anne Mugenyi Bitature describe their actions unprofessional, unethical, and an abuse of the integrity of the judiciary, saying such behavior has no excuse. The students are Anne Kakidi, Mary Zerida Nabiye, Paul Katsime, and Kellen Karunji. Meanwhile, the Law Development Center has also undertaken the initiative to handle the issue within the confines of its internal disciplinary procedures. A private security guard who murdered a 27-year-old IHK doctor, Catherine Agaba, and dropped her body in a septic tank has been jailed for 20 years. Ken Ronald Obongo has pleaded guilty to the offence of aggravated robbery and murder in a plea bargain session going on before Judge Anthony Ajok Anyur. Facts as read to the judge show Obongo, who was guarding GPS apartments at Muyenga Bukasa Parish in Kampala District, got so agitated with the doctor would threatened to report him to his bosses over his bad conduct. Obong, in fear of losing his job, decided to kill the doctor, dropped the body in a septic tank where police discovered the body after 2 weeks and robbed her of a home theater, a gas cooker, mobile phone, a flat screen TV, and utensils, among others. Obong first informed court he was a minor, aged 17 years, when he committed the offense on April 12, 2019. The prosecution insisted and produced a medical report indicating he was then aged 24. Judge Anthony Ayuko Ojok said excuses of being a minor cannot water down the act of murder he committed, as it was so grave and gruesome and took away a life who would have been so useful now in the corona pandemic, as the country is short of medical practitioners. Hence, sentencing him to 20 years. In sports news, Uganda Cranes head coach Jonathan McKinstry has confirmed changes in the team to play Niger tomorrow in the last game of the pre-Chan mini tournament hosted in Cameroon. Uganda drew 1-1 with Cameroon as well as defeating Zambia 2-0 in the previous two games of the Four Nations tournament. After today's training, McKinstry confirms changes will be made in the starting lineup against Niger.
So yes, there'll be changes again tomorrow. I think probably we'll see some players from the first game coming back into the lineup, but equally there'll be some players from the game against Zambia retaining their place. And it's really just trying to get the combinations correct. but also understanding that it's not just about having 10, 11 players. We need to make sure that if we get injuries, if we get suspensions, you know, if we get fatigue throughout CHAN, that we're able to make replacements and that the players coming in are comfortable at taking up those positions on the team, and just the units and the combinations are comfortable as well.
In other news, Nigeria expects to get its first batch of COVID-19 vaccines by end of this month as part of its plan to inoculate 40% of the population this year and a further 30% next year. The head of the country's primary health care agency has revealed the first batch would contain 100,000 doses of the Pfizer BioNTech vaccine obtained through the global vaccine sharing scheme known as COVAX. Nigeria will first inoculate frontline health workers, first responders, national leaders, people and vulnerable to coronavirus and the elderly. The country hopes to get 42 million vaccines to cover one-fifth of its population through the scheme. The World Health Organization set up the COVAX scheme to help poorer countries obtain COVID-19 vaccines amid widespread concerns that wealthier nations would snap them up. South Africa's President Cyril Ramaphosa said last week that the country expected to get vaccines through COVAX scheme by the second quarter of 2021, following the initial payment of 283 million rand, which is 19.3 million US dollars. Health Minister Zweli Mkhize subsequently said the government was also in talks with private pharmaceutical companies to obtain vaccines by next month. South Africa's government has been under intense pressure to roll out an inoculation program following the discovery of a faster spreading variant of the virus. And that was the news of
XFM News on point.